In this section, we'll take a look at the tabs and views that come pre-configured with any installation of SAM, along with a few other useful resources. Then we'll talk about the Real-Time Process Monitor and the Service Control Manager. SAM Standalone comes pre-configured with three different tabs: Home, Applications, and Virtualization. Each tab has a default set of views that provides specific information related to each topic. With each module installed afterwards, new tabs will appear for that module, similar to Network tab for NPM and Configs tab for NCM. The Home tab is designated to contain a dashboard-style view of the monitored information for all installed modules and is included in all Orion products. The Application tab is specific to SAM and will provide you with server and application-related data, including status, performance, and hardware health statistics. The Virtualization tab provides a high-level view of VM hosts and their resources. As with every area of the Orion Web Console, these tabs can be customized by the administrator and configured to use specific menu bars by default, per user, by group, and even hidden from certain users. Like the other products in the Orion family, SAM comes pre-configured with a set of standard views, showing the most pertinent information about server and application performance, availability, and health. All SAM-specific views are accessed from the Applications tab in the Web Console, though application resources can be added to other dashboard views. First, as with all Orion products, there is a summary view called SAM Summary. Here you will find a high-level summary of applications and critical components, all with the powerful drill-down capabilities common across the Orion family of products. The next four menu items provide a single application view, such as Active Directory, Exchange, SQL Server, and IIS monitors. And of course, the Orion platform provides the flexibility for you to create your own application-specific views. For help in creating your own custom views, refer to Customizing the Orion Web Console in the Network Performance Monitor training series. In the SAM Summary view, the first resource available is All Applications. Here you will find a list of all applications SAM is monitoring along with their status. You can also drill down into any application or its components in order to view the status and performance details. By editing this resource, you are also given the option to select how you want the monitored application displayed. Typically, customers like to see the list of applications followed by the servers that application is being monitored on. So let's go ahead and change this view. Below that resource is a handy listing of applications with problems that provides a quick at-a-glance view of where my trouble areas are. Moving to the right side of this view, the first resource is an application health overview, providing a breakdown of up, critical, warning, down, and unknown statuses for applications. This is a great resource to add to any dashboard page, and the status levels include the drill-down capabilities to take you directly to the applications that are in a critical or down state. Directly below that is the hardware health overview, providing a breakdown of statuses for server hardware. So if I see a critical hardware issue, I can immediately drill down to see which servers are having those hardware issues, and further to see what those specific issues are. This server looks like it's having several problems, including a bad stick of memory. Next is an area for application maps created in the Orion Atlas application. For further information on creating custom maps, refer to Orion Network Atlas in the Network Performance Monitor training series. Finally, there are several top 10 lists to give users a quick look at applications with high memory, CPU, or other critical values. From here, clicking on the applications or component will take us to a more detailed view, showing specifics around the issue. From the application or component details view, we'll use the Real-Time Process Explorer to look closer at what's running on the server. This feature is very similar to the Process tab found in the Windows Task Manager. However, the advantage to using Real-Time Process Monitoring is that you can do it right through the web console, without needing to log into the machine to view and manage these statistics. If you've ever tried to remote into a server using 100% of CPU, you'll know exactly what we're talking about. The Real-Time Process Monitor can be accessed in a few different ways. The easiest is directly through the Application Monitor Details page. The Explorer will open in its own window and track processes, allowing you to sort by any column. You can also stop processes from this window. However, if you wish to use this feature, the node must be monitored using WMI. If you hover over any column, a down arrow will appear. Clicking the down arrow allows you to add or remove columns from the view to provide you with information you are looking for. If the process is included in an assigned application template, it will show which one is in the assigned application column. You can also drill into the application details view by clicking on the assigned application template. If not, you will see the Start Monitoring option, which will allow you to immediately start monitoring that process. You can click this button to launch a new instance of the web console and assign that process to the application template of your choice. Finally, you have the option to pause or start the real-time polling or to use different credentials for monitoring. When you are finished monitoring processes, simply close the window. The Service Control Manager allows you to monitor and manage services in a similar manner as managing processes through the Real-Time Process Monitor. Here you can start and stop services, pause and resume polling, as well as start monitoring a service not currently watched. As with stopping processes, if you wish to stop and start services, you must be using WMI to monitor the node. You can also hover over a service to view details about the service in a tooltip window. The Node Management resource provides features for managing the node. Edit Node allows you to change the polling method, dependencies, custom properties, and other settings on the node. List Resource allows you to change the resources being monitored, such as hardware health. In addition, you can manage and unmanage the node, poll the node on demand, as well as access the Real-Time Process Monitor and Service Control Manager. You can also run the Rediscover feature to detect changes in the node, such as host name or disk volume details. Node Management also gives you the ability to reboot the server if desired. In order to use this feature, the server must be monitored via WMI. Once you choose to reboot the server, SAM will give you a warning message confirming that you want to reboot before the action is carried out. Permissions to reboot a server are configured in the User Account Settings under the SAM Specific Settings area. And permissions to reboot is applied globally, meaning that if a user's permissions are enabled, they can reboot any server they have access to in SAM. For further information on creating custom maps, refer to Orion Network Atlas in the Network Performance Monitor Training Series.